Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, we are from Group 1. We will present about the implementation of parasitoids as biological agent. And before we start our presentation today, I will introduce our members. And next. First one is me, Farika Reta Mujarini, with student number 060. Nita Amelia Dewi, with student number 097. Corinne Adelina Putri, with student number 186. And Dian Ardana Yoga with student number 217. Next. Parasitoids. What is parasitoids? Parasitoids are animals that live on or in the body of another larger animal as their host. Parasite attack can weaken the host and can intentionally kill the host because the parasitoid eats or sucks the host body fluids. They are parasitic in their immature phase, while in the adult phase, they live freely and are not attached to their host. Next.
The advantage of parasitoids as biological agent. What is high parasitoids to prevail has potential risk? Then parasitoids only need one or a few individual hosts to complete their life cycle, and then the parasitoid population can still survive even at a low population level. And then most of the parasitoids are monophage or polyphage, so they have a narrow footprint. And this causes the parasitoid population to have a good numerical response to change in its host population. Next is the weakness of parasitoids as biological agents, such as the search for parasitoids against the host is often influenced by weather conditions or other environmental factors that change frequently. And then the female insects, that's quite a major role because they are looking for a host for laying eggs. And then parasitoids that have high search power will generally produce fewer eggs. This is the implementation of parasitoids as biological agents.
The first one is Apontales sp. Hymenoptera progenidae. This attacks Eurema blanda or yellow butterfly. The larva body will harden and turn black. Endoparasitize by laying their eggs in the larva body. Mechanism is this parasitoid parasitize its host insect by laying eggs on the surface of the host skin or inserted directly into the host body by puncturing the ovipositor. Then, after the parasitoid larva have hatched, they will suck body fluids or eat body parts from their host. Next. Okay. And then, family Enchiridae and family Benchonidae. Biological control of stem borer or buckthorn, Cistrocera festiva on Sengon plants use parasitoids. The parasitoids found in eggs, festiva eggs, are from the Enchiridae family, while the parasitoids found in eggs festiva larvae are from the Brachyonidae family. Family Brachyonidae is a group of parasitoids that can be endoparasitoid or ectoparasitoid. Next. Okay, and then it's Trichogramma chelonis. Egg parasitoid Helicoverpa anhydra on maize and tomato plants. Female insects can reproduce parthenogenesis. A female is able to produce as many as 20 to 50 eggs. The life cycle is 10 to 11 days, can be bred with a substitute host, namely Corsira sp, so that its utilization is developed intensively. Imago size is very small, 1 millimeter or less, so it is difficult to observe in the field.
And then diadigma semiclausum. Plutella celestella larva parasitoid on Quebec. The female insect has an ovipositor at the end of the abdomen and can lay eggs in all Plutella celestella larva instar. The life cycle of the diadigma semiclausum from eggs to adult is 18 until 20 days in the highland and 14 days in the lowland. While the eggs, larva, and pupa are 2 days, XD, and egg until 10 days, respectively. And then conclusion. Parasites are insects that parasitize insect or other arthropod. They are advantages and disadvantages of parasitoid. Parasitoid can be implemented in various types of plants, such as diadigma semiclausum as a parasitoid for Plutella celestella pest on Quebec plants and also Trichogramma chelonis, which is an ex parasitoid of Helicoverpa armigera. Okay, that is presentasi from our group. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.